Hi guys. Welcome to this tutorial on Maps R 485. The basic feature of the app is to show the map of your current location on your watch. Therefore, your watch must be paired to your phone via Bluetooth, and your phone must be connected to the internet. The first thing that the app does when you open it is to get a GPS fix, and then it tries to download the map of your current position. If everything works well, you should see a little map of your area, and your position will be indicated by a blue dot. If you start moving, an arrow will indicate the direction that you go, and if you walk too far from your start position, the map will be automatically updated. When you open the menu, you will see more functions. Some of them are quite basic, such as Update Map, which will refresh the displayed image, or Zoom In, and Zoom Out, which will change the zoom level of the map. The other functions have to do with our route. To create a route, we must enter the coordinates of the points where we want to go, and the app will show the distance and direction to each point. Let's check an example. First, I will use Google Maps on my phone to find the coordinates of a point where I want to go. I see that the latitude is around 51.026, and the longitude is 3.691. Now, on the watch, I choose the option Add Coordinates, and enter those numbers. After we type the coordinates, the point is added to the route. The screen changes automatically to the route view. We can already see that the point is in my northwest. If we just scroll back to the previous screens, we see the distance, and the direction to that point. Instead of typing the coordinates manually, we can use Save Current Location, and Save Destination. These options will respectively store the coordinates of our current position, or the coordinates of the last point we added to the route. Later, if we want to add them to another route, we can just use the option Add Save Location, instead of Add Coordinates. That's how we would manually plan a route. However, if our route consists of many points, it's better to use a different approach. The first automated way to create a route is the Android app. You can download it for free on the Google Play Store. After you download and open it, you should grant the permissions for the app to write on your local storage and to access your location. I recommend you close the app after granting those permissions, to ensure that the changes are applied. When you reopen the app, you just have to type an address. Then choose, Set as Destination. And, Send, to the watch. Before you send, you may want to check the route that was created, and that can be done by clicking Show. This is how you would see the route on your watch. Some watches are able to request directions from Google without the Android app. You just have to open the menu and choose the option Google Directions. Then you can enter the coordinates of the point that you want to go, or you can choose a previously saved location as your destination. With a VivoActive HR, you can also search for an address, using a touch keypad. Now some tips and tricks. The app usually tries to determine the next point on your route. When you are close enough to this point, your watch will vibrate and the app will show the distance and direction to the subsequent one. If the app makes a wrong guess, you can always correct it by opening the menu and choosing Go to Next or Go to Previous. In some cases, doing it will disable the Auto Advance feature. If it happens, you should use the menu to enable it again. In addition to the map screen, there are three very useful screens that show the route and your position on it. The first one shows the full route, and the points are numbered. The second one is basically the same, but without the numbers. And the third one is centered on your position. You won't see the full route, but, instead, you can focus on the points which are closer to you. This is all for today. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you soon.